Monica's up next in Manteca, California, on Immaculate Heart Radio. Monica in Manteca, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hi there. Hello.
Hi. Okay, so I have a question that came up in Bible study, and I hope it's not a stupid question. But so I'm wondering, at what point did the church officially kind of like declare or recognize that Jesus was not just the Son of God or the Messiah or the Christ, but that actually meant that he was God?
Right.
Like,
it's a great question. Great question.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here's the answer is the church has always taught that Jesus was God all the way back to the very beginning. In fact, the very earliest Christian writings we have, for example, St. Ignatius's letters, his seven famous letters that he wrote to seven churches on his way to martyrdom, teaches that Jesus is God. So, and that was written about 107 AD. So Jesus was understood to be God because he revealed himself as God. The apostles understood that he was God. In fact, it was revealed to St. Peter when Peter says, you know, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. The fact that he understood that Jesus was not just a Son of God, but the Son of God, meaning Son by nature, that tells you that we're talking about, just as my son Timmy has the same nature that I do, that revelation. In fact, Jesus says in Matthew chapter 16, verses 18 and 19, when that revelation was given to Peter, he says, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of John, for flesh and blood hath not revealed this to you." This is something that's beyond our natural ability. This was revealed to St. Peter, that he's the Son of God. And just as my son Timmy has the same nature I do, Jesus was revealing himself as having the same nature as his father. And we have unanimous writings down through the centuries from the fathers and the early. In fact, an interesting study to do is to look at some of the reactions in the early church against those who first begin to call into question whether Jesus was God. And when they did, they were quickly pounced upon. You know, and interesting point too. When you look at the epistles, the main objections against Jesus were not against his divinity. It was really against his full humanity. You know, you see John, for example, in 1 John 4, verses 1 through 4, he talks about if anyone denies Jesus Christ is come in the flesh, the same as Antichrist. So the argument wasn't so much whether he was God or not, it was whether he was fully man. But then later on, of course, you did have those, like Cerinthus. In fact, I have a new CD set on the Eucharist that's coming out here any day now, where I talk about one of the early heretics by the name of Cerinthus. He was one of the first that denied the divinity of Christ. And John spends a lot of time on him in the Gospel of John, as well as the book of Revelation. But if you read John's Gospel, for example, John hammers home the divinity of Christ more than all the other gospel writers by far, and it's because John was dealing with an early heretic by the name of Cerinthus who was denying, among other things, he was denying Christ's divinity. So this is why, you know, John will say it in such plain terms. And by the way, this is one of the reasons why it was so clearly understood in the early church by all the fathers of the church, because John was so plain. He starts off his gospel. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. It's like, any questions, folks? In fact, in John 5:18, John gives us his commentary on what Jesus was teaching at a particular point. And he says, and they sought to kill him, not just because he broke the Sabbath, but because he called God his own Father, making himself equal with God. That's John's commentary saying as plain as day that he's God. Or as you know, and I'm sure you know, in John 20:28, St. Thomas the Apostle, when it fully hits him who Jesus Christ is, he says, "My Lord and my God," to Jesus. And we could go on. But just remember that the church has always taught for 2,000 years that Jesus is God. However, there were definitions that were given, for example, at the Council of Nicaea, that defined in a fuller sense what we mean by saying Jesus is God. For example, the Greek word homoousios, or same nature, was used at the Council of Nicaea to define infallibly how we work out this idea of Jesus having the same, and that's what that means, same nature, the same nature as his Father. But see, a lot of folks mess up here, and they think, well, it was invented by the Council of Nicaea, the divinity of Christ, in 325 AD. And that is absolutely not true. It simply is a definition defining in more detail what had always been taught by the church. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. Thank you. And can you repeat again the name of the heretic that you said John addressed?
Yes, Cerinthus. That's Cerinthus. Get my new set on the Eucharist. We have a lot of fun. In the very first of the four CDs, I go into great detail on that.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Monica and Manteca. Appreciate it.